Right, this your brother Aisha Yar coming at you with another lesson. First off, I want to give all praises to Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham Rekah Kodesh. Double honor to the apostles of the great millstone, which I learned this truth from. Honors to the elders and brothers out there pushing this word through the four corners of the earth within truth and sincerity. And shalom to the Akwath that's listening and learning. Today's video is going to be entitled Destruction and Salvation. Destruction and Salvation. Now I got inspired to do this lesson because of this video that was uploaded by GMS Get This Work 2. And if you are not subscribed to this channel, definitely subscribe to it. There's a lot of edification over there. And he uploads a lot of powerful videos like this that I'm about to show you all. And pretty much the name of this video that he uploaded is In 1 Hour, Boom. And as we all know, America is going to be destroyed by thermonuclear destruction. And America is going to be destroyed within 1 hour, all right? And within America being destroyed, the elect is going to be saved right before the total destruction, okay? Yahweh Shai and the angels are going to come back, and they're going to help destroy America. They're going to be shooting the laser beams everywhere, you know, the concentrated fire. They're going to be shooting that everywhere. Yahweh Shai is going to be doing his thing, okay? And they're going to ultimately destroy America, okay? And like I said, I got inspired to do this lesson because this video right here is very powerful, man. Like, I really love these videos when they come out. It's a few brothers that brings out these videos like this, man, where they show you images, you know. They show you images. They show you actual movement, you know, cinematic type scenes and everything like that. And it kind of gives you a glimpse into what it's going to be like. You know, you could just use your imagination and you could just see that, man, this is actually going to happen, man. All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play this video. And so you all can see for yourself, because I had to watch this a few times, man, because it really hit my spirit, man. It really did. And I really appreciate this video. So I'm going to go ahead and play this video, and then we're going to grab just a few scriptures. So let me turn the phone this way and let's get right into it. Play it again, man. Let's play that the second half. Woo, powerful, man.
Oh, praise the dream.
very, very, very powerful video, man. Like, this video, like I said, instantly put me in the spirit, and it got me to the point where I'm just like, man, this is what we want, and this is what we're trying to avoid, okay? Because we want America to be destroyed, because if America is not destroyed, that means we're going to continue to be here. And we definitely do not want to be here, man. This place would drive you insane. It already is. All right? We do not want to be here. We want to get up out of here and finally live within a righteous kingdom. Okay? But we do understand, before we get to the kingdom, this has to happen. America has to be destroyed. And we don't want to be destroyed within it, man. We want to make it. All right? Like I said, you saw the arrows, which are the missiles. Because that's what the scriptures tell you what the missiles are. They say they're arrows, all right? They're going to shoot from one end of the earth to the other. Because Russia and other countries, they're going to shoot their missiles over here, okay? And as soon as the missiles are getting ready to be shot over here, that's when the so-called UFOs, which are the chariots of Yahweh Basham Yahweh Shai, that's when they're going to show themselves. And they're going to save the elect from being destroyed within that thermonuclear destruction, man. All right? So at the end of the day, we need to keep fearing Yahweh Basham Yahweh Shai. We need to keep doing what we need to do for the brotherhood. Keep prophesying. Keep doing what we need to do, because we know that this place is over, man. It's only a matter of time before the Most High put the spirit upon Russia and these different countries and upon Esau to destroy himself, man. All right. So let's go ahead and grab a few scriptures. I'm gonna have to download that video in my phone personally, because I don't that video is where it's at. I'm not even gonna lie, man. So this is Malachi chapter 4 verse 1. It says, "For behold, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven, and all the proud, yeah, and all that do wickedly shall be stubble. And the day that cometh shall burn them up, saith the Lord of hosts, that it shall leave them neither root nor branch." So the day that's gonna burn as an oven is the day where America, aka Babylon the Great, is going to burn in 1 hour, all right? The whole country is going to burn, all right? This is going to be the biggest desert on the planet Earth, all right? And everybody that does wickedly is going to be within that nuclear fire. There's going to be no escape, okay? The Most High is going to make sure that you stay there. And when a lot of people that's going to receive that judgment are the people that's going to take the MOTB, which is the CHIP. That electronic tag that Esau is going to make mandatory very, very soon. Because the scriptures tell you in Revelation 14:9, if you take that, you're going to be in the fire. Okay? And then, of course, you know, the Most High is going to have a lot of people be within that fire as well, because a lot of you all out there is going to be worthy of that judgment. Okay? So at the end of the day, the ones that's listening to these videos, not just my videos, but, you know, from the apostles and the elders and the bishops on down, all right, the ones that's listening to these videos and taking this word seriously, hey, keep praying to Yahweh Basham Yahweh Shai so you won't be a part of that two-third club, man. We do not want to be here when this place get ready to be destroyed. All right, verse 2, it says, "But unto you that fear my name shall the Son of Righteousness arise with healing in his wings, and you shall go forth and grow up as calves of the stalls." So the ones that fear the names of Yahweh Basham Yahweh Shai, those are the ones that's going to be saved, which are the elect, all right? And he's going to use the chariots to get his elect out of here, and they're going to be the first fruits of the kingdom, all right? They're going to be the first fruits of the kingdom, and man, the elect is going to have stories to tell, all right? So now let's get Isaiah 26 and 20. This is Isaiah chapter 26, verse 20, and it says, "Come, my people, enter thou into thy chambers, and shut thy doors about thee. Hide thyself as it were for a little moment until the indignation be overpassed." What's the indignation? That's the Most High's righteous anger. That's Yahweh Basham Yahweh Shai's righteous anger. Because what he's getting ready to do to America is a righteous act. This place is overly wicked, man. It's polluted with wickedness, as the scriptures say in 2nd Ezra. All right, everything that we see, everything that we encounter, everything that we listen to, the people that you speak to on a daily basis is just wicked, man. It's full of sin. These people are not fearing the Lord, and they don't want to do anything that's righteous. So the Most High has to make a move, and he's getting ready to make a move. That's why it says, come my people, enter thou into thy chambers. What is that? The chariots. You're going to enter, you're going to get beamed up into the chariots, and the doors are going to be shut. You're going to be safe from the thermonuclear destruction that's getting ready to happen to America. And it says, hide thyself. That's right. We're going to be hidden, man. We're going to be safe. We're going to dwell in safety finally, man. The elect will dwell in safety. All right. Ultimately, all Israel is going to dwell in safety in the land of Israel, but the elect is going to be first. All right. So we want to make sure that we enter into those chambers. This is why the scriptures say, make your calling and your election sure, because a lot of us have been called into this thing, but we do not know if we're chosen. So the only way that you can possibly know if you're chosen is if you keep being within this truth and you keep doing what you're supposed to do day in and day out, man. You keep praying, you keep fasting, and Lord willing, you make it. All right? But you can't half-ass yourself, man. You got to make sure you're in this thing 144%. Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah requires nothing but people that's on fire. No, he doesn't require anybody that's cold, and he doesn't want anybody that's lukewarm. Okay? Verse 21, it says, for behold, the Lord cometh out of his place to punish the inhabitants of the earth for their iniquity. That's right, all of their sins, like I was speaking about earlier. This place does not acknowledge the Lord, and this place lives off so-called do as you will. You can live whatever type of way you want, and these people are cool with it. People can openly be, you know, part of the letter community. People can openly do whatever they want. People can openly, you know, just believe in whatever they want to believe in, and they feel like that's cool, but it's not. All right, the righteous power, which is Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, they're getting ready to set up the kingdom. They're going to show you what's righteous, and that's going to be within the commandments, statutes, and laws. All right, and it says, and the earth also shall disclose her blood and shall no more cover her slain. So at the end of the day, the Most High is going to destroy this place because of the iniquities that keeps on happening within this earth. It has to stop sooner or later. All right. People are depressed. People are emotional. People are full of diseases. People are starving. People are dying. People can't even think correctly because they're eating all this GMO food. The air is polluted. The water is messed up. More and more animals are becoming extinct. The children of Israel, which consists of you Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, you keep getting slaughtered and you keep getting dumbed down. Something has to happen. And Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah is getting ready to make it happen, man. All right. Let's get Revelation 18 and 9. This is Revelation chapter 18, verse 9. And it says, and the kings of the earth who have committed fornication and lived deliciously with her shall bewail her and lament for her when they shall see the smoke of her burning. Who burning? America. The different countries that shot the missiles over here, they're going to feel sorry and they're going to feel bad that they actually shot the missiles over here, because they're going to realize that a lot of the ties that they have with America is no more. Because these different countries make money through America, man. And once they realize that America is no more, they're going to be like, damn, what do we do now? You know, because they're going to have to realize that they're going to have to start from the bottom. But the thing is, they won't even be able to start from the bottom, because these heathen nations, all of them, are going into slavery. And they're going to realize that as well, because they're going to see the Lord. They're going to see the chariots. They're going to see the 144,000. And they're going to realize this is it. There's nothing they can do. They're going to realize that they messed up, but that's all through the plans of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai anyway. All right. Then verse 10, it says, standing afar off for the fear of her torment, saying, alas, alas, that great city Babylon, which is America, that mighty city, for in 1 hour is thy judgment come. So over 200 million missiles are going to be shot over here, or 200 million missiles, Salakia. 200 million missiles are going to be shot over here, okay? And it's going to destroy America within 1 hour. 1 hour. And it took this place centuries to build, man. And it's going to be gone within 60 minutes. 60 minutes. That fire is going to reach, man, that fire is going to be tall. It's going to be hot. And this is why we pray to Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, that we are not part of it. We do not want to be part of it. We want to be looking down from the windows, man. We want to be looking down from that glass. We want to actually see America burning. We don't want to be a part of it, all right? So let's get one last scripture and close it out. Let's get Romans 13. We're going to get Romans chapter 13, and we're going to go to verse 10. And it says, love worketh no ill to his neighbor, therefore love is the fulfilling of the law. That's right. This is how we show Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, that we love them by following the commandments, statutes, and laws. Right now, we're rehearsing the righteous acts because we cannot keep the law 100% on this side. But we do what we can do within our, you know, our lives, all right? Whatever you can follow, that's what you do, all right? And because ultimately, faith is what's going to get us out of here, because as soon as all of us reach that hour of temptation, which is the MOTB, that's what's going to seal your fate of whether you're part of the elect or whether you're part of the two-thirds, all right? You're going to have faith at the end of the day. Verse 11, and it says, and that knowing the time, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep. For now is our salvation nearer than when we believe. That's right. It's time to wake up out of this world, and it's time to realize and understand and pay attention to what's going on in the world and get ready for what's getting ready to happen, which is the destruction of America, man. Because as soon as America is destroyed or getting ready to be destroyed, that's when our salvation is going to be right there as well. The chariots will show themselves full blown, like we just saw in the video, and they're going to beam up the elect. They're going to beam up the elect, and we're going to be in safety, man. Verse 12, it says, the night is far spent, the day is at hand. That's right, the day is at hand. Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai's day, the destruction of America, the kingdom of heaven, the return of our Lord, Yahweh Shai. The day is at hand, man. It says, let us therefore cast off the works of darkness and let us put on the armor of light. That's right. Stop doing evil. Stop doing wickedness. Stop living in iniquity and start living by the ways of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai. Let us, verse 13, it says, let us walk honestly as in the day, not in rioting or drunkenness, not in chambering and wantonness, not in strife and envying. But put ye on the Lord Yahweh Shai Hamashiach, and make not provision for the flesh to fulfill the lust thereof. That's right. Because the lust of this flesh will get you destroyed. When you start loving the things of this world, it distracts you from what's really going on. All right. So at the end of the day, you need to pay attention and always meditate on Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai. Always meditate on this wisdom that he has blessed you with. All right. So we need to put on the whole armor. We need to be spiritual. The scriptures say in Ephesians, the sixth chapter, it says, this is a spiritual warfare, man. We need to always be spiritual and actually acknowledge and think about what we are a part of, and be happy and blessed and grateful that we are a part of something that's big, man. Hey, he called us into this, so we need to, you know, endure to the end. So, hey, at the end of the day, we need to endure to the end and keep doing what we need to do for the Lord. And Lord willing, we make it, man. All right. So I'm going to end it right there. So I hope this is edifying. So with that, I'm going to say, call Halayim, Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Rekai Kodash. Double honor to the apostles of the great millstone, which I learned is true from. Honors to the elders and brothers out there pushing this word through the four corners of the earth within truth and sincerity. And Shalom to the Aqua that's listening and learning. And Yahweh Rat Tazad, I'll be back with another lesson. Keep pushing, Yasharala. Keep pushing. We almost out of here. Shalom.